Welcome to Applaud Tutorials. In this tutorial, we trigger an integration using workflow. This time, we're posting a message in Slack. First, consider why your organization might need to post a message in another application, like Slack. In this example, we've built on top of the functionality found in the Badge Cabinet template. Using a workflow with a trigger integration action, we've created an automatic process that posts a congratulatory message in a Slack channel when a badge is awarded to an employee. You might choose a different purpose or application for your configuration. To make the most of this tutorial, you'll need a basic understanding of models, workflows, pages, form blocks, and integrations. Check out our handy resources on these topics on the Knowledge Base and YouTube channel. The Badge Cabinet template contains the badge model. We use this to populate our tenant with several badges we can award to employees. The template also contains the Person Badge model. This uses foreign key properties to the person and badge models. The Award Badge page contains a form related to this model. When a user selects an employee in a badge, the badge is awarded and displayed on their profile page. We wanted to post a message in Slack when a badge is awarded. To do this, we first needed to create a new workflow in the Person Badge model. We set this workflow to trigger on form submissions and included a trigger integration action that is going to link to a recipe. Before we move to the next step, ensure you have a working connection to your Applaud tenant using the Applaud connector. If you need a reminder on how to set this up, check out our handy resources. At this point in the process, we needed to create a connection to our desired third-party application. To do this, head to the Integration section from Admin Home. Head to the Assets tab and select Create, then Connection. Search for the app that you would like to connect to. We use Slack. Choose a name for your connection, then select a location. Complete any other necessary fields and select Connect. Now head back to Assets and select Create again. This time, select Recipe. Enter a name and location for your recipe. Then pick a starting point. In this example, we chose Trigger from an app. Choose your trigger app and event. Then configure the steps you want to happen from there using actions. This is our completed recipe. The properties we needed for the Slack message content were foreign key types, so we had to add search actions to the original models to retrieve the data. Without the search actions, we would be presented with the IDs in the Slack message, rather than the data as you see it in Applaud. Here is the finished configuration for the message we posted in Slack. To show you how this works, we're awarding a badge to an employee and following the automation process. Make sure you have activated your workflow and started your recipe. In this example, we're awarding the team player badge to Georgina Robson. As you can see, a new message has appeared in our desired Slack channel. This is set up exactly how we designed it in the Post Message in Slack recipe action. Additionally, we created another recipe to alert users in the same channel when a new badge is created. In this example, we created a badge for company culture. When we select Save in Applaud, a new message appears in the channel. Congratulations! you have successfully completed this tutorial. Learn more at Applaud Academy or check out our knowledge base at support.applaudsolutions.com.